For more on this, we're joined live by investigative journalist Webster Tarpley, who joins us from Washington, D.C. So all eyes are now on Pakistan, where Osama bin Laden was killed, and reports are suggesting that the government was sheltering the terrorist leader for years. But how is this possible if the country is indeed one of the major victims of terrorism? I mean, do you think that's really believable?
Let me say, first of all, what I have to say about bin Laden is based on a 500-page, rather exhaustive book that I've written, 9/11 Synthetic, Made in USA. I think this is a completely manufactured, invented story created out of whole cloth by the U.S. intelligence community, primarily for the purpose of targeting Pakistan. And there's been a buildup to it. We had a very harsh statement condemning Pakistan in one of the terror reports of the U.S. government. We had Admiral Mullen visiting Pakistan, accusing them of being accomplices of the terrorist Haqqani network. We then had the CIA limited hangout operation known as WikiLeaks targeting Pakistan. The Washington Post putting that on the front page. The center of gravity of Al-Qaeda was always Pakistan. And now we have this manufactured story. Abbottabad, allegedly the hiding place, the lair of bin Laden for the past 6 years. It's totally fantastic, but the purpose is clear enough. They're targeting Pakistan for more attacks. The Chinese government has understood this immediately. We have a very strong statement from China this morning, basically saying to the U.S., if you mess with Islamabad, you will be messing with Beijing, and this will get into something much bigger than you thought. The main danger right now is false flag terror events, in reality organized by the U.S. or by NATO intelligence, that will be blamed on Pakistan. And indeed, we have this from several CIA people in the media here saying there will be revenge terror attacks, but they'll be coming from the Inter-Services Intelligence Network. That is the much demonized ISI of Pakistan. And you can see this is a complete setup. So people need to be vigilant in that regard.
The U.S. says it has photos of slain bin Laden. ABC News is reporting right now that they may, in fact, release them today. But why don't you think they release them right away and get all the skepticism over with over the death of bin Laden?
I can't speculate about that, but I'm sure that whatever they release will essentially be a fraud. The real bin Laden has been dead for a long time. And for the last 6, 7, 8 years, you've been hearing primarily audio statements from a kind of production company located probably in Pakistan.
All right.
Unemployed actors.
I'm sorry, Webb. I'm going to move on here now because this is one of the many conspiracy theories that we've been talking about yesterday and today. Yes, they're out there. You're talking about it. We had a guest talk about it yesterday. The Taliban's talking about it. I'm going to move on. Many agree that the U.S. foreign policy prompted the attack of, prompted the dawn of Al-Qaeda back in the 80s. That's no secret. Now
sure.
It's supporting rebels in Libya who allegedly have links with extremism. How long do you think the U.S. may continue a pattern of arming extremists or possible extremists who later there's blowback from?
Well, this is the tremendous contradiction is that the United States is openly supporting Al-Qaeda forces, which represent a large part of the Benghazi rebel council in Libya. In Libya or in Yemen, Al-Qaeda is one of the main tools of the U.S. in destabilizing the government. One suspects that in Syria and in Algeria, that's also the case. But then, in sharp contradiction, if you're Al-Qaeda in Afghanistan or Pakistan, then you have to be bombed. And this is an unsustainable contradiction. It just makes absolutely no sense. I think what we're actually seeing is the decline of the U.S. empire. If you look back at the fall of the Spanish, the French, the British empires, in those cases, the fall of the empire has been accompanied by world wars. Now, if the United States decides to go after Pakistan, trying to split Pakistan into Sindh, Balochistan, Punjab, Pashtunistan, you're going to get a collision between the United States and China. And at that point, Russia will also have to respond in some way. What you're seeing is how the decline of empire can lead to war by miscalculation. The U.S. ruling elite is in a frenzy because they are trying to stop Saudi Arabia and Pakistan from leaving the empire, from making a jailbreak, from bolting out from under U.S. hegemony. So that is why they've chosen to liquidate hundreds of billions of dollars they've invested in the mythological figure of of bin Laden. They wouldn't be doing that if it weren't something big. It goes far beyond Obama's fortunes at the polls. It's an attempt to try to save the U.S. position in the world. I think it's very unlikely
to succeed.
All right,
Webb, I'm sorry to cut you off, but we're going to have to end it there. Investigative journalist Webster Tarpley.